Right. So in today's class, we will see about shell scripting. So basically, the shell scripting is related to the Unix or Linux, and we can use shell scripting to write a certain programs to achieve specific tasks. So it is kind of a simple programming concepts, like we can define the variables, or we can use the conditional statements, and we can use the looping statements and so on. So basically, shell scripting is nothing but a collection of multiple commands. Suppose in Unix or Linux, if you want to perform a certain task, you will proceed or will provide some commands, individual commands one after the other. So for example, if I want to execute a group of commands to achieve a specific logic or specific task, I can group all the commands and put it in one file. That is called as a script file. Now, when I execute the script file, it will produce the output, just like a normal Java, C, C++ programs. So shell scripting is basically a scripting language which is by default there in the Unix or Linux. So now let us understand what is shell and what is shell scripting and what are all advantages and how we can use this shell scripting and not. So basically, if I observe this, let me share presentation just a second. Right. Now, if I see this particular picture here, operating system having multiple components. Any operating system, it can be Windows or Unix or Linux. Based upon the architecture, they have certain components. Especially for the Unix or Linux, there are few components. So for example here, hardware is a one component. Okay, without having hardware, system will not work. Hardware is a one component. Hardware by default there. So if you want to work with this hardware, suppose if hardware should work, we should have operating system. Suppose if you want to work with the system, operating system is mandatorily required. Right? So operating system we will install. And once you have an installed operating system, then you can install any other softwares in your system, you can work on that. So hardware is the main one of the component, and the user, because user means whoever is interacting the system, he is called as a users. So here's the hardware and user. These are the two important components. So if you want to work with the system, system means it's a collection of hardware components. Then intermediately we require operating system. So this is a basically operating system. So what is an operating system here? An operating system is an interface between the user and the hardware. Operating system is an interface between the user and hardware. But if you consider only the operating system, what are all things operating system contains, especially for Unix and Linux? So in the Unix, we have two components mainly. The one is called operating system contains two parts. One is kernel, the other one is called the shell. Kernel and shell. So operating system is the collection of kernel and shell. And terminal is an editor kind of stuff. We can interact with the different commands. Here in terminal, we can execute all types of commands. Okay, so terminal is like a notepad or VI editor kind of thing. So where we can execute all our commands. So those commands will execute against the shell. Against the shell. First terminal will interact with the shell. Shell will talk to the operating system. So kernel is a component which have all kinds of operating system related files. Okay, system files. So this is a operating system internal architecture. Now here we need to consider about these two things. Shell and terminal. So if you want to interact with the shell, we have to interact with the terminal. Terminal is an editor or an interface from where we can interact with the shell. Now let us understand what is shell. Shell is nothing but a command interpreter. So whatever commands we are giving an internal terminal, those commands are interpreted by the shell. Interpreted means it will execute basically. On the line by line, it will check each and every command. For example, here I say copy command. In a terminal, I'll say copy command. So who will understand this command? Shell will understand the command and this will execute. Similarly, whatever commands we are running in the dollar prompt in the Unix, all those commands are being interpreted by the shell. Internal shell is the command. Okay, there are many number of shells are there, like bash shell we have, corn shell we have, C shell we have. So there are number of shell types are there based upon the operating system and their flavors. Even the Linux itself, there are many number of flavors. Like Red Hat Linux, EAX, okay, so Ubuntu Linux. So there are n number of versions are there, or flavors are there. So here shell is a, again different types of shells will be there for different flavors. So shell is a basically is a component which can interpret our commands, whatever commands we are giving in the command prompt. This is all about the shell. Shell is a command interpreter which will interpret the commands which are giving in the terminal window. That is the first thing. Second thing is, what is shell scripting? Shell scripting means, in the terminal itself, we will create certain files like this. We will put all the commands, list of commands, whatever we require, and save this file as a .hs extension. Hs means shell script. Now, when I execute this sh file, all these commands will be executed one after the another. And these commands internally interpreted by the shell. So this is basically called as a shell script. Shell is an interpreter which will execute all our commands. Shell scripting is nothing but a collection of a group of commands which we can put in the one file, and we can execute that file against the shell in the terminal window. Okay, in the terminal window, we will execute the shell file, and shell will interpret those file and it will perform certain task. So that's basically shell script. Now, what is shell scripting? Shell is a command interpreter, as I said. Shell is a command interpreter. Usually in the Linux or Unix, we will see dollar symbol, right? So there we will execute all the commands. So this is a basically shell prompt is a dollar prompt. And group of commands can be executed with a single stroke. What does that mean? Group of commands we can put together in one file, and within a single stroke, if I run the file, automatically all the sequence of execution of commands will execute sequentially. Okay. So what is a script file? Script file contains a valid commands, all the Unix commands, valid commands of Unix or Linux. Okay, that file is called as a script file. Okay, so the script file can be created by cat command or vi command, whatever. Okay, you can create your script file and we can put all the commands. Okay, so how we can execute the script file? So this is the command. Sh is a command. And we have to give the file name. So sh here, the optional extension is the optional. Okay, so if you want to give .sh, mean that is a script file. Even though if you don't give sh file, by using this command, file will be executed. So how we can create the script file? By using vi editor or by using cat command we can create. How we can execute the shell script file? By using sh command in the command prompt. Okay. So sh command will execute this particular file even though we don't have any write and read any permission, because this is just execution part. Execution is defaultly happen. Okay, we don't need to specify any special permissions. Okay, and now we will see how we can write the shell script and all one after the another, and then we will discuss those points. Right, now we understood what is shell, what is shell scripting. So let me write a simple point. Anyway, I'll provide the notes. Shell means command interpreter. Simple definition. Shell is a command interpreter. What is a shell script? Shell script is a file. A file contains valid commands. File contains a valid Unix or Linux commands. Unix or Linux commands is called a shell script. How to execute the shell script? How to create the shell script? By using vi editor, let us say test is my file. So here we can execute all the commands one by one. Means we should not put any data here. Okay, we have to put only commands, like command one, all the Unix commands, valid commands we need to put, or command two, and so on. Or we can also create this particular file by using a cat command. Okay, in the same, you can say cat test. So test is my script file. So this is also other way of doing, but instead of creating the cat, go for the vi editor, because this is most frequently used editor, vi editor. Okay, and this is how we need to create the shell script. After creating this, how to execute the shell script? Execute shell script file. So how to execute? In the dollar symbol, let us say simple, we can say sh file name. That's it. So this will give you an output. Okay, so now let us see the basic commands, how we can write a shell scripting. So if you want to write a shell scripting, first we need to learn a few commands, right? So just like a language, if you want to write a sentences, first we need to right, first we need to start with the learning alphabets and then words, and then we can write the sentences. Similarly, any programming language or any scripting language, if you want to learn, first we need to understand the basic things, like what are the keywords are available, how we can use those keywords, and then slowly we will write different kinds of programs. Now let me show you a small example how we need to create the shell script file and how we can execute. So first, before writing the shell script, I'll introduce one command called as echo command. Echo is a command. In shell script there are n number of commands. I'm going to discuss one by one after the another. So echo is a first and very important basic command. So this particular command will print the output in the command prompt or display message, display messages. Okay, now I'll use this command in the shell script and see how we can create. Let me list what are the files currently we have. Let me remove test. Yes. Okay, fine. So now let me show you ls. I don't have any files here. So now I'm going to create one shell script file. Okay, so how to create command is vi. Vi is a command, it will open the editor kind of thing. So just like a notepad. So there we can execute all our commands. Vi. And let me say test. So this is my script file name. And press enter. Now we enter into the Vi editor. So this is basically called as a Vi editor. Here we can execute all the, here we can provide all the commands. But Vi editor is having two different modes. As soon as you open the Vi editor, you cannot directly type the values here. Okay, currently it is just open the file. So if you see the bottom here, it is showing just a file name and this is a new file. Okay, so directly we cannot provide these values. So we need to change this Vi editor into insert mode. So how to change this insert mode? Press insert key in your keyboard. Okay, press insert key in your keyboard. As soon as you press insert key, the command here in the bottom you can observe, currently this Vi editor is changed into insert mode. So now insert mode is started. So now you can write your commands here. So in this, now what I will do is I'll use echo command, just echo, or if you want to put some comment, you can use hash symbol. Okay, hash is used for commenting. So this is my, this will ignore at the time, at the runtime. Okay, this particular statement will be ignored. So this is my first shell script file or shell script program. Okay, this is just comment. Now I'll write a simple message in the cell. Echo. Echo means use it for it display some message. Let me say welcome. And then one more echo. Echo like two. Echo training. Okay, so echo is a command which will display the what are the messages we have provided. So now I have three different statements I have given, three different echoes I have given. So once we have completed giving all these commands, again we need to save and exit this particular file. We have to save and exit from this particular file. So how we can do that? Currently we are in the insert mode. Now we need to press ESC key in your keyboard. So in VA editor you need to remember two keys. One is insert key and the other one is ESC key. So insert key, when I press insert key, it will allow us to put the commands in the VA editor. As soon as you completed putting all the commands, press ESC key, again it will change to the normal mode. Okay, ESC, now it is a normal mode. Then we need to save and exit from the VA editor. For that we need to use one command called colon. So at the bottom it will automatically type this colon WQ, and WQ means WQ colon. So this command will save and exit. If I give only Q here, small Q colon, it will just quit from the editor. It will not save the data. Okay, without saving these details, it will exit. So we have to create WQ. So there are three commands you need to remember in VA editor. There are n number of commands, but regularly we use these commands. One is press insert command. Okay, to change to insert mode. Okay, to provide commands. Okay, second one is a ESC key. SAQB is again exit from insert mode. Insert from a normal mode. And WQ colon. This is command used for save and exit from VA editor. Suppose only if we give Q colon, this is only exit without saving. Exit without saving. Right? So these are the commands. Now let us see. Currently I am WQ colon. Now I have saved this one. Now if you want to see this data, just cat test. Now you have these commands. Okay. Now we have just created a shell script file. Now I need to execute this file. So how to execute this file? Let me clear. So how to execute this file? The command is sh test. Now when I execute this enter, now you can see it is giving you output welcome to training. Okay, but we used only echo command. Echo means this will display whatever message we have given in the script file. Okay, so this is my first. Let me rename this file. Okay, this is my first script, right? Just I'm renaming this test. I name it as a script 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Okay, script 1. Right, so this is my script here. Right, so this is a echo command. Echo command will display what are all messages we provided in the shell script, that will be displayed. Right, so this is how we can create a script file, shell script file, and then we can use echo command and then we can execute the script file. Now let us see one more command. We have seen echo command, right? So one more command, read command. So what this read command will do is it will read the data, read input from the user. Read input from the user. Now let us see one more example. I'll create one more shell script. Okay. VI read input. Read input. So this is my file name, shell script file name. Press enter. Now we enter into the VI mode, VI editor. So here if you want to put some commands, we need to change to insert mode. Now press insert key. Now we are in the insert mode, right? So now we can give the commands. Now this is an example for just better to put some commands. Okay, later point of time you will know what kind of program it is. So hash is a simple comment. Even though if you don't provide, nothing will happen. Okay, so this is shell script for reading input from user. Now what I want to do here is I want to take some input from the user and then I want to display the message. So whatever input is taken from the user, the same message I wanted to print. Okay, that's my intention. So how I can do is first echo. Okay, so we need to expect some input in the user. So let me put some message. Enter your input. So enter your input. So whatever message we have typed here, the same message will be applied at the runtime. So now after entering the user input, we are providing it as a user, we need to provide the input at the runtime. So where we need to store that output, we required a variable. So the command we need to use is read, let us say name. Okay, so enter your input. Instead of that, enter your name. You can put enter your name. So whatever name we entered at the runtime, that name will be stored in the particular variable read name. And after that I want to display the name. Again, if you want to display the name, the command is echo. I cannot directly print like this. Okay, so if you want to print like this, we need to use dollar symbol. So in the name variable, already the value is there. So whatever value we entered in the runtime, that value is captured in the name variable. If you want to extract that value from a variable, we need to use a dollar symbol. Okay. So before that, if you want to write some meaningful message, you can still write it. Your name is colon, like this. Okay, so this particular value with dollar symbol extract the value from a variable. So whenever we want to extract the value from a variable, you need to use dollar symbol in front of the variable. Okay, now this is a simple script. It will expect some input from the user and store that input in the name, and then after that it will print that. Now completed. Again, we need to change to normal mode. Press ESC key, then colon WQ. Exit, save and exit. Now we have created the file. How to execute message? Read input. So this is my shell script file. Press enter. Now it is asking us to enter your name. So I'm entering my name here. Now press enter. Now it will give you your name is and so name. So this is an output. Okay. So this is how we can use read command. Read is a command which will take the input from the user. It will take the input from the user. Okay. Right. Suppose if you want to extract the value from a variable, then we need to use a dollar symbol like this. So here I have used a dollar symbol. Right. So this is another example. Now let me show you a few more examples. Let us discuss the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. So we have different kinds of arithmetic operators in shell script, like plus is addition, minus for is subtraction, okay, slash is star, this is for multiplication, okay, slash multiplication, slash star combination we have to use, and this is for division, and this is for modulo division. So these are basically called as arithmetic operators. Now let us see how we can use these arithmetic operators. Now I'll create one more shell script. I'll name it as arithmetic operators. If you want to give .sh, you can give it. Okay, sh is the shell scripting extension. Normally in the notepad we give .txt, right? Similar. .sh is the extension of the file. Arithmetic operators.sh. Now here I'll enter all these commands. Now let me use how we can use arithmetic operators. Now I move on to the insert mode. Okay, so I'll comment here arithmetic operators. Okay. Now here I'll take two numbers. A is equal to, let us say, 20, right? So B is equal to 10. Okay, so if we give dot sh command, so you will see the differences, color variables and all. If you create normal file, you cannot see these colors and all. Okay, if there is any mistake, it will show immediately. So now I have created two variables, A is equal to 20, B is equal to 10. Now I want to perform certain arithmetic operations in between these two variables. So for that, what we need to do is, suppose if you want to add these two numbers, this is the way we need to add. Suppose I have here A is equal to 20, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. If I want to add these two numbers, how we can add is, how we can extract these values A and B, we have to specify the dollar symbol. Dollar A means it will give you 10, and dollar B means it will give you 20, right? So if you want to extract these values, we need to use a dollar symbol in front of the variable. Now we need to add these two variables. If you want to add these two variables, give plus operator. Okay, give plus operator. Make sure there should be some space here, there should be some space here. After that, this is not enough. After that, what we need to do is, there is a one ascent symbol in your keyboard. Ascent symbol is, this is the ascent symbol. Okay, just see the difference, people will confuse here. Ascent means this is the ascent symbol. Let me increase this font. Okay, no. So this is ascent symbol. And this is a single quote. There is a lot of difference, okay. This is ascent symbol, this is a single quotation. People always use the single quotation, that is correct, not correct. Okay, this is wrong, it will throw you an error. So what we need to do is put this statement in the ascend operator. So not this one, this one, here once and here one more. After that, one more keyword we need to give, expr means expression. So this is how we need to use, okay? This should be used. Okay, this is not correct. Remember this too, okay? So where this symbol is available under, you have a number piece, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So before 1, there will be till symbol. So there is a one key called it with the till symbol like this one and this one. So with these two keys, these two symbols, you have only one key in your keyboard. So that you need to press. So this is basically called as an ascend symbol. This is called as an ascend. Okay. Right. So now this is a, this is called ascends. This is not a correct. The first one is correct. So if you want to add these two numbers, first we need to extract these values. How we can extract? By using dollar symbol here and here, and then we need to perform the addition operator, and it will not enough. We need to put everything in the expression expr, and everything we need to include in your ascend symbol. Okay, this is a notation, right? So now come back to your scale script. Now you want to add these two numbers. So echo, I'll say sum of A and B, sum of A and B. So how we will get up sum of A and B, or else let's say like this, sum. How to get sum of A and B? Even if you want to directly print, you can print. Okay, we can write meaningful message later. So echo, ascend symbol is mandatory. So this is my ascend symbol, dollar A space plus ascend symbol. Again dollar B, that's it. So this will give you addition of these two numbers. First let us try only this part. Escape, colon, double Q, save. Now we need to execute this one. SH, arithmetic operators dot SH. Press enter, and it is giving arithmetic operators line number 6, command not found, because there is some issue with the command. Let us check line number 6. So line number 6 is this one, right? Echo, expr is missing here, right? So expression we have to give. Again insert mode, expr space, okay, expression. So now again save the file, small letters, WP, both are small, press enter. Now again run the file, sh, arithmetic operators dot sh. Now you can see it is giving your output as a 30. Similarly, we can also add few more arithmetic operators. Now here, again go to insert mode. Okay, I'll copy the same stuff. So now first one is addition, second one is subtraction, minus, third one is multiplication. Multiplication means slash and star. And then this is division, and this is a modulo division. That is called percentile. This time we can delete. If you want to delete, escape key, DD is a shortcut command. Right? Now I have used all arithmetic operators. Now if you want to put some meaningful message in front of here, you can put again. So insert mode, and here you can write sum of A and B, and here difference of A and B, and this is multiplication of A and B. Here division of A and B. This is just meaningful message, okay? Modulo division of A and B, right? So now we have used all kinds of operators. Now we can execute this file, escape, colon W, exit. Now SH. So now we can see the output here. Sum of A and B is 30, difference is 10, multiplication 10 into 20. 200, this is the division. Modular division means it will basically returns a remainder. Okay. And this is the coefficient, division and modular division. Okay. So this is the output you will get. So this is how we can use arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. Now we will see few more examples. So I want to write a script file that finds sum of two given numbers. Okay. So solution is write a shell script file to find sum of two numbers. Okay, this is my problem statement. Write a shell script to find sum of two numbers. Sum of two given numbers. So those numbers I want to provide at the runtime. Okay. So now let us see how we can write this. I will create another shell script. Let me clear this. How to create vi? My shell script file is sum of two numbers dot sh. Okay, sum of two numbers dot sh. Press enter. Now we enter into the vi editor. So press insert key. You change it as insert mode. Now here I can write the command. So two inputs I need to take from the user, two numbers, right? So first let us say type echo, let us say enter first number. So after entering the first number, it will take that number into some variable. We need to use read command, read num1. So num1 contains that value. Now again we need to read one more value. So echo enter second number, right? So now again this value we need to read. So read num2, second value we have read. Now currently we have num1 and num2, two numbers. We need to add these two numbers and then print those numbers. So if you want to add these numbers, add and then store in one variable. If you want to add these numbers, how we can add? First, we need to extract this value from a variable by using dollar num1. Next, arithmetic operator. Again, dollar symbol num2. Right? Not only this, we need to put in ascend operator and expression relay, expression operator. So ascend operator, expr, space, and here again we need to end with the ascends. This is a full statement which will give you sum of two numbers. Now if you want to print this, we need to use echo command, right? So echo command we need to use. So before write, we need to store this value some variable. Let us say c equal. I want to store entire value in the c. Now I want to print this value, echo dollar c. Why you need to use dollar? Because C have value, but if you want to extract that value, we need to again use dollar symbol. Okay, now this will give you sum of two numbers. Or if you want to write a meaningful message, you can add sum of two given numbers is dollar C. Okay, now escape colon double equal. Now execute this sh sum of two numbers dot sh file. Press enter. Now it will ask you the number. So I'll give 100. Now it will ask you the second number. I'll give 200. The sum of two given numbers is 300. So this is how we will get the output. Okay. This is a simple example to add two numbers or two given numbers. Okay. Now we have few relational and logical operators in shell scripting. Now let me show you. So these are the relational and logical operators. So basically relational and logical operators are used for checking certain conditions, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal to, and etc. So in shell scripting, in the normal other programming languages like C, C++ and Java, we use these symbols directly. Greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and so on. But in shell script, we use this keyword. GT means greater than. -LT means less than. -GE means greater than or equal to. hyphen LE means less than or equal to. Hyphen EQ means equal to. Hyphen NE means not equal to. Similarly for logical operators. Hyphen A means AND. Hyphen O means OR. Hyphen N is NOT. So these are the relational logical operators. Now let me show you how we can use relational and logical operators. Relational operators. So these are the relational operators. Let me put it here. Hyphen GT is for greater than. Hyphen LT is less than. Hyphen GE is greater than or equal to. Hyphen LE is less than or equal to. Hyphen EQ is equal to. Hyphen NE is not equal to. So these are the relational operators. And the logical, hyphen A is AND. Hyphen O is OR. Hyphen N is NOT. So now let us see how we can use these variables. So if you want to use these relational operators and logical operators, we need to learn the conditional statements. So just like other programming languages, in shell scripting also we have conditional statement, like if condition, if else condition, nested if else condition, and so on. Now we will see conditional statements, and then you can also understand relational and logical operators. Conditional statements. So in the conditional statement we have simple if and if, else if, and finally nested if. So these are the three different conditional statement we have. Now let us see how we can execute these commands. So how we can, so why we need to go for conditional statements? Conditional statements are used for checking certain condition or controlling our code. Okay, so usually if I write a shell script, it will go line by line. But whenever I want to verify certain condition, okay, and if condition is true, certain number of statements should execute. If that is false, another set of statements should execute. If I want to do that, what I should do is I need to put certain condition. Let us say this is a code. If certain condition is matched, some other set of statements should execute. If the condition is false, and normal other statements will execute. Okay, if yes or no. So we can control our execution. So for that we need to use a conditional commands. So now let us see how we can use simple if statement. Simple if statement. The syntax of this like this. If, so within the bracket put some condition, and after then here we need to create statements. Statement 1, you can put any number of statements. Statement 2 and etc. After that else, here else false statement or another statement. If a condition is wrong, what are the statement we need to execute, or statement something else. And finally F5 means here it is if we started, here it if is ended. Okay, so if condition, here we need to give some space, and then statement set of condition. If the condition is true, then part will execute. If the condition is false, else part will execute. This is the syntax, right? Now we will see a small example for this. Write a shell script to find biggest of two numbers. So how we can find biggest of two numbers? I will give those two words at the runtime. Okay, now let us write a shell script for this. Vi, and creating another shell script. Vi biggest of two numbers dot sh. Okay, right, so now press insert key. We are entered in the insert mode. Now here we need to give the command. The first we need to take the input from the user. So echo enter first number. Okay, and store that number in a variable. Let us say read A. Now again echo enter second number, and store that number in B. Now I have A and B. Now we need to check the condition. How we will say whether which one is greater than? If A greater than B, okay, if A is greater than B, then A is big. If A is less than B, then B is big. Right? That is the condition. Simple condition we need to put. So now here I'll put one conditional statement. If bracket, here we need to say dollar A. So if you want to extract the value of A, dollar A need to specify. So dollar A space hyphen GT greater than dollar B. This is the condition. If dollar A greater than dollar B. If this condition is true, what else we need to execute here? I need to say echo. Simply I can say A is largest. There is another keyword called then, right? If this condition is true, then echo, okay, and A is big. That is my message. Okay, else if the condition is false, else again echo B is big. Okay, after that we need to close this if condition. So for that if I, that's it. So this is a simple program we can write, shell script, to compare these two numbers. If A greater than B, then A is big. If this condition is false, obviously B is big. Okay. So if you want to print instead of A and B, you can directly print the value, then you can use a dollar symbol here instead of this. Okay, then the number will display. Right, so now we have run this code. So save this file, escape, colon W, exclamatory mark. Now we have saved shell script file. Then we need to execute sh biggest of two numbers. Press enter. Now it is asking the first number. I'll say 10. Second number is 20. Now we can say there is some issue with the line number. Biggest of two numbers. Command not found. It's giving 20 is a big, but in this line number 6, it is showing some error. Let me check. Line number 6. So here it is giving some error. If dollar A hyphen greater than dollar B, I don't think so. Here there is space. Okay. Yeah, space will not be there. Now let us save this. Again, run the same code. First number is 10, second number is 20. Whoa. Again, one more error. Syntax error near unexpected token. Then, so now let us modify again. Okay. Insert mode. This space should be there. If yeah, here one space before dollar A, after dollar B, there should be some one more space. Here one space, here also we need to give some space. And spaces you need to make sure, okay. If your spaces are not correct, then script will not execute. Right, so now SH. Now I'm giving first number, second number, now 20 is big. Again, I'm running the code. First number is 200, second number is 100, now 200. Okay, so this is how we can execute. Right, so this is a code can execute the I. So this is how we can write the code for if condition, simple if condition. So here, this is a relational operator. Okay, suppose if you want to use logical operator. So all like this, all the relational operators are like this. Greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal to. Similarly, I will also use logical operators. So now the same program, I will just modify with else if condition. Okay, this is a one condition statement we have seen. Another condition statement, if, else, if. So this is a second conditional statement. And the syntax will be like this. So first if condition, and here within the bracket put condition. If this condition is true, then statement 1, and you can write any number of statements, statement 2 and so on. After that, again if you have one more condition, then else. Okay, else again one more condition. If here condition 1, here condition 2, this is the condition, again then statements, statement 3, statement 4 and etc. Okay, and finally we need to close inner if statement and then we need to close outer if statement. So fi and fi. So this is a syntax of if else if. So multiple if conditions. So if then else, if a condition having one more if. This is basically if within if condition. Okay, there are two ifs. This is a syntax. Now let us see one example for this. So same above program. Now what I will do is, let us find largest of three numbers, not one number. Write a shell script to find biggest of three numbers. Okay, now we use this particular conditional statement along with the relational operator and then logical operator also come into the picture. Okay, now let us understand this logic here. So if you want to find largest of three numbers, let us say A, B, C, three numbers I am taking as input. So how we can verify which one is the largest? If A greater than B and A greater than C, in this case A is largest. But this is the first algorithm. Similarly, if B greater than A and B greater than C, then B is largest. Right? B is largest. Suppose if above is not true, then finally C is largest. This is the only remaining case. Okay. So now let us implement this shell script. Now, Ctrl W. Fine. So let me create this. I'll create one more. Largest of or biggest, right? So LS. Okay. So VI. Biggest of two numbers we already done. So this is three numbers. TH, three numbers. Press enter. Now insert. Here first I'll read three different numbers. So read A comma B comma C. You can give like this. Okay. If you want to read three different values from the command prompt at the runtime, you can directly read multiple values also, not only single values. So A, B, C. So three values I will give, three numbers I will give at the runtime. Those three numbers will be stored in A, B and C. Now the first condition. So what's my first condition? This one. A greater than B and A greater than C. So condition is if space bracket, one more space. How we can get those values? Dollar A greater than means hyphen GT, again dollar B. This is the first condition. Okay, dollar A greater than dollar B, and one more operator we need to give. So and, how to give and operator? Hyphen A is a and operator, and again dollar A hyphen greater than dollar C. So this is a condition. So what does it mean is, the first operator is this one, A greater than B and A greater than C. Both conditions should be true, then only the final condition becomes true. If A greater than B and this is AND operator, hyphen A is an AND operator, logical operator, and A greater than C, if both the conditions are true, then only it will return true. Now here print then echo A is largest or A is biggest. So instead of A, just print the value. If put dollar symbol, it will print the value. Okay. Else. So there is another condition. Else. Again, one more if condition. If. So here, dollar B. So this time B. Dollar B greater than and dollar C. If B is greater than A, and hyphen A means and dollar B hyphen again greater than dollar C. Okay, what does it mean? The second condition. First condition is over. If A greater than B and A greater than C, A is largest. If B is greater than A and C, then B is largest. So now second condition I am putting. If the first condition itself is true, A is biggest, it will display. And second condition, it will not execute. It will not go to the second condition. If the first condition is becomes false, and then only it will come to the second condition. So now here, if B greater than A and B greater than C, then echo dollar B is biggest. Okay, so two conditions have been done, and after that else part. So we don't have any other conditions. So else part is enough. So else echo and C is largest. That's the only value we left. C is biggest. So this is a simple shell script we can write. After that, we need to close this if condition. Here one more if, and there is outer if. So for that, F5 and F5. Fine. So this is how we can write the shell script for finding largest of three numbers. Here we have used greater than relational operator, and also and is a logical operator. Now save this file. Now let me run this file. SH biggest of three numbers. Press enter. Now we need to provide three numbers, right? So let's say 10, 20, 30 I have provided. Now it is giving some issue. Missing, there is symbol, which line number 3 as well as 7. Now let us modify. Line number 7 it is saying, right? So 7 means this is the 7. So here and here dollar A greater than dollar B hyphen A and dollar A hyphen greater than dollar C. Okay, here dollar B greater than dollar A and dollar B greater than dollar C. Echo B is largest and C is largest. Fine, let us see. 10, 20, 30. Line number 3 and 7, biggest of 3 numbers. Command not found. That is biggest it is giving, but small issue we have. Line number 3 and 7. Again, there's some spaces issue. Let me check. Insert mode. Line number 3. Write once again. If okay, after if one space, here also we need to give some space. Okay, greater than hyphen A greater than hyphen C. Here also we need to give one space. Fine. SH 10, 20, 30. Now we say 30 is the largest. Now I'll give you different order. First 500, 300, 100. Now 500 is biggest. Okay, so this is how we can execute, we can write the code by using relational operators and logical operators. Okay, so now we have one more command, another if condition, third one, nested if condition. Nested if condition. So nested if in that sense, if condition having one more if condition. Internally we have one more if condition. So multiple if conditions. Okay. So let me show you. So it will be like this. Let me share your presentation, then you can understand. Now you can see here. So this is outer if condition. So this is outer if. This if condition. Just a second. Right. This is a outer if condition. So this condition will end here. Okay, here starting and here end. and if condition, one more if condition. So here this if is ended here, and this is outer if is ended here. If condition is true, then execute this statement. And after the along with this statement, one more if condition inside the if, one more if. If contains one more if. Again, this condition is true, then this statement else. If this condition is false, then else part will execute. Okay, so this is a basic nested if else statement. Let us see this example, how we can perform this example. So for this, I'll write a syntax here. First, if bracket condition, then statements. Along with this, it will be like this. And within the statements, one more if condition. If condition, then statements. And these statements are part of the internal if condition. Now, for this if, I need to write one else part, right? So else, and in the else part, we have another statement. So this particular if should complete here, F5. Now this particular if condition is true, then it will go and do that. If condition is false, then for this if, we need to else one to write one more else part, else statements. Right, so this is a nested if condition. Now let us write a program to print a number is even number or odd number. Okay, I'll give some number, you need to say that is an even number or odd number. So that's my program. And before checking even number or odd number, first it need to check whether the number is positive or not. If it is a positive, then check even number or odd number. Okay, if it is a negative number, we cannot say even or odd number. So if you want to say even number or odd number, first of all, that should be a positive value. Right, after 1, if value is less than 0, should not give any output. So this is the condition. So check the given number is even or odd. Okay, so before that, the prerequisite is number should be positive. Check number is positive or not. If it is a positive, then check the even or odd. Okay, this will be like this. First check number is positive or not. Okay, if positive, then check even or odd. So this is a logic. So first we need to check positive or not. If positive, check even or not. If not positive, okay, else if not positive, check not positive. Just display not positive number. Okay, this is the condition. Right, so now let me create one more shell script. Vi even or odd dot sh insert mode. So now I'm going to write a command. So first I need to take the number from the input, right? So read n. So this number is given by the user. Now I need to put certain condition here. So the first condition I need to verify is whether the number is positive or negative. So if condition, so bracket here, dollar n, because n is contains the value, dollar n greater than 0. So this is a condition, dollar n greater than 0. That's the first condition. That means that's a positive. Then what I should do now, I should check even or odd number. So before that, let us print echo number is positive. Okay, so if this condition is true, the number is positive, and immediately what I should do, I need to verify the number is even number or not. If it is a positive, right? So number is positive, we know now. If the condition is true, this number is positive. Then we need to check whether number is even number or odd number. For that, again we need to put one more if condition. So before that, how we will know whether the number is even or not? If any number is divided by 2 returns a 0, that is an even number. If any number is divided by 2 which is not return the 1, that means a not even number. So we need to write one expression here. Let us say R equal to and ascends expr expression $n divided by 2. Okay, $n is divided by 2. So just capture this value. $n divided by 2. So either returns 0 or 1. Okay, that will be stored in R. Now verify the condition. If condition $r-equal to 0, then we can say echo number is even number, right? So if this condition is true, then we can say number. Else, okay, here one more then is missed here. Then else, suppose if r is equal to not 0, then else part will exclude. Else echo number is odd number. Just a second. Right, so number is even or number is odd number is decided. Fine. So now suppose if the number is positive, then we are verifying the number is even or odd. Suppose the number itself is not positive. When it will happen? If the first if condition is false, then number is not positive. So that we need to specify here. So after else, we print a number is odd number. After that, close the internal if condition. This condition is closed here. And then else. So this condition is there, right? Else. Print here echo number is not positive. Number is not positive. That means a negative. It's a negative. After that, we need to close the first if condition. So fi. Okay, so that's it. So now we can exclude this. So now let me explain this. Let me copy this in notepad, then you will understand. So this is the code basically. If the first condition is true, okay, then I'm executing this. Again, I'm condition checking here. If I put like this, then you can understand clearly. Okay, just a second. Fine. So now you can understand here. So if the first condition is true, when this will become true, if the number is positive, then it will become true. So $n greater than 0, that means a positive number. Then we are saying number is positive, and then we are dividing that number with the 2. It returns 0, that means r. If the r is 0, then number is even. If r is not 0, else number is odd. So here this if condition is done. When this and all will execute if the condition is true. If the condition is false, obviously that is a negative number. So else echo number is negative, and finally if condition is closed here. This is a program. Fine, so now let us execute this. Go here, save this code. Now sh even or odd dot sh, press enter. Now we need to provide a number. Let us say 10. So it is giving some error. Line number 3, the condition is giving wrong error, not found. Line number 4 is syntax error. Okay, 3 is basically having some error. Let us check the 3. Run on this one. So line number 3. So the condition, I think each is the if condition is wrong. If $n hyphen greater than 0 gt. Just a moment. So if here one space, after if here one space, here one space, here and here, and same thing will applicable here. If $r if n equals 0, here also we need to give some space, right? So now execute, sorry, lowercase letters sh. Okay, so 10 number is positive, but it is not giving any equal operator. Line number 6 and 7 is giving error. Let me check it. Line number 6 and 7. 6th one is r equal to. Okay, here the expression is wrong. Expr, expr dollar n percentile 2. Okay. Let me write once again. Here we should not give any space, internal space should be there, right? So I'm giving 10. Yes, number is positive and also even. One more time, I'm giving odd number this time. So number is positive, odd number. Now one more time, I'm giving minus value, let us say 4. Number is negative. Okay, so this is how we can write the if condition. So these are all called logical and relational operators. Okay, so this is how shell scripting will be. So we can continue this in the next class.